it was the quickest turnaround for an NBA season in regards to obviously lack of an offseason, really. The draft and free agency really was going 100 miles per hour. Kevin Durant made his official return to the court yesterday. Tripp, what were your thoughts on Durant and Kyrie finally playing together? And what, aside from the Lakers, of course, what are you excited to see for this upcoming season?
Well, yeah, first, let's get that out of the way first. Definitely excited to see the Lakers and get the repeat campaign going. But outside of that, I ain't going to hold you. Kevin Durant looked good. Him and Kyrie, you know, they look good together on the court. I mean, we all kind of, you know that the Nets had a good team anyway. And then, you know what I'm saying, because they were a playoff team before Kyrie and Kevin Durant got there. But when you add that type of – when you add two superstars to that type of depth, I think as long as they can stay healthy, they're going to be really good. And I'm actually excited because I feel like there's a good chance, you know, that we could get Brooklyn versus LA in the finals. And I was talking to my cousin yesterday. He's like a huge Kobe fan, you know what I'm saying? So he didn't want to like budge on this. But I was saying that if we get to see this LeBron team versus this Kevin Durant team where things are even, and now it's like we can really see who's the best as they go ahead up. This can be similar to what we wanted to see with Kobe versus LeBron that we never got in the finals.
That's a very fair point. And you're right, because in the two prior instances or teams they were on, because they've met in the finals several times, but the first time Miami's team was more experienced and more talented. The Oklahoma City was good. Right. Oklahoma City was very young. They were just scratching the surface. Obviously, Harden wasn't even a starter then. He was coming off the bench. And that wasn't MVP caliber Russell Westbrook yet either. And then the second go around, obviously, it was tilted the other way. Golden State was the powerhouse, and LeBron had good teammates, but they weren't on the level of what Golden State had at that time. So it is a fair point. It could be the closest we've seen the two superstars in their prime, who we all regard as the top two guys in the game. I don't think anyone is debating if Kevin Durant is the number two player in the world. I think we all kind of agree that that's where his spot is right now. But I do think, and I've been highly critical of the Nets over and over. I'm not going to hide from those points that I've made in the past. And I still think they are probably the biggest wild card in the Eastern Conference because, yes, if they're healthy, sky's the limit for them. We know what KD can do. We know what Kyrie can do when he's healthy. We know they have budding young stars like Caris LeVert, like Jared Allen. They've got veterans.
Hey, man, don't look at my main man, Spencer Dinwiddie.
Right. Well, I didn't put him in that category because he's a little older. He's not the young, budding star. All right. But I was going to say, in terms of the veterans, Spencer Dinwiddie, Joe Harris, DeAndre Jordan. So they've got a really good collection of pieces there. But ultimately, can Steve Nash make it work? And that's why I think they're the biggest wild card. Because when you compare them to the other teams in the East, Brad Stevens, amazing coach, right? Nick Nurse, amazing coach. Doc Rivers, amazing coach. Coach Bud in Milwaukee, very good coach. So there are a lot of good teams in the Eastern Conference that they're going to have to try to figure out how they can beat. Oh, by the way, and I don't want to even forget this guy, Eric Spoelstra, who just was in the finals last year. So there are a lot of good coaches that Steve Nash is going to have to figure out how to outmaneuver in big playoff moments. But it was good to see Kevin Durant on the court yesterday, man.
And that's not to say that Steve Nash can't get there, because we just don't know at this point. But when you talk about levels to coaching, you know what I'm saying, these are our top guy, Spoelstra, you know what I'm saying? Like, these are top guys. Doc Rivers, they're all highly respected coaches. You know what I'm saying? And that's not to say that Steve Nash can't get there, but he's never actually coached even in a regular season game. We ain't start the regular season. He's got literally his coaching experience as a head coach is one preseason game.
Correct. Yeah. We got to take a wait and see approach. Yeah. I mean, this thing, it could be beautiful. If these two guys gel with the other pieces and they make it work, it could be absolutely beautiful. And they may have a first year similar to LeBron and AD, where they're the best team in the conference. If they don't gel and it doesn't work, they could look like the other LA team that got bumped in the second round of the playoffs.
Smush Parker here, formerly of the Los Angeles Lakers, and you are now tuned in to Real Fans Real Talk.
Real talk, we as real as you thought. Real